From the very beginning of creation, you have made manifest your love. When our need for a Savior was great, you sent your Son to be born of the Virgin Mary. To our lives, he brings joy and peace, justice, mercy, and love. Lord, bless all who look upon this manger. May it remind us of the humble birth of Jesus and raise up our thoughts to him who is God with us and Savior of all, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen.
Good afternoon. Let us turn our thoughts to God's love for us and sing hymns together, remembering the events of that first Christmas. All songs can be found on your green handout. Please join us as we begin with Angels We Have Heard on High. The world around, our churches joyfully resound with children singing, robed in white and dressed as angels in the night, proclaiming Christ our Savior's birth to sheep and shepherds here on earth. For unto you this day is born a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. So we may go as shepherds then to meet our Lord in Bethlehem. If there are any children present who would like to join our angels up here, bring your song sheets and come on up. Struck with fear and awe at what they heard and what they saw, inspired by angels in the sky and barely understanding why, prepared to travel to that place where they might see this child of grace. So, acting on that holy news, they marched with lambs and rams and ewes, already wakened from their sleep, those shepherds and their woolly sheep. Traveling on to Bethlehem, they found all as had been told to them. So beside a manger filled with hay, where Jesus Christ our Savior lay, shepherds bowed before heaven's light, praising God on this wondrous night. Those humble shepherds brought gifts too, of woolly sheep, ram, lamb, and ewe. Then sheep and shepherds a vigil kept in reverence while the child slept.
Thank you.
wise men traveling far to find this king beneath a star brought gold and myrrh and frankincense worth sums of money quite immense. To honor Jesus, these were not of greater value than gifts brought by humble shepherds and their sheep, whom angels roused from midnight sleep to tell the news that Christmas morn, it is for you that Christ is born.
So I get the chance to mess up your makeup. genuflect when we say, born of the Virgin Mary. Third, we pray the intercessions, the prayers of the faithful, kneeling down. And four, it's not for you, but for the little children who have been made for this communion, when everybody receives Jesus in hand, you all could go to that tree and pick your favorite, whichever, you know, ornament you want. I don't know whether Jesus would see if you take two. Otherwise, it's the regular Sunday. So let us calm ourselves for a second and bring to God whatever that we are grateful in our life. We know we didn't have the heart of Jesus always. We know we made poor choices. We know the times we failed to be the best of ourselves. we pray and bring to Jesus all that we were asking to healing, all those whom we were listening to them, and all that we are grateful. So we ask Jesus the light to come into our life, our families, and bring the light and peace.
Let us pray.
O God, who have made this most sacred night radiant with the splendor of the true light, grant, we pray, that we who have known the mysteries of his light on earth may also delight in his gladness in heaven. Who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of prophet Isaiah. The people who walk in darkness have seen a great light. Upon those who dwell in a land of gloom, a light has shone. You have brought them abundant joy and great rejoicing. As they rejoice before you, as at the harvest, as the people make merry when dividing spoils, for the yoke that burned in them, the pole on their shoulder, and the rod of their taskmaster, you have smashed as on the day of Midian. For every boot that tramped in battle, every cloak rolled in blood, will be burned as fuel for flames. For a child is born to us, a son is given us. Upon his shoulder dominion rests. They name him Wonder, Counselor, God, Hero, Father, Forever, Prince of Peace. His dominion is vast and forever peaceful. From David's throne and over his kingdom, which he confirms and sustains by judgment and justice, both now and forever. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to Titus. Beloved, the grace of God has appeared, saving all, and training us to reject godless ways and worldly desires, and to live temperately, justly, and devoutly in this age, as we await the blessed hope, the appearance of the glory of our great God and Savior Jesus Christ, who gave himself for us to deliver us from all lawlessness, and to cleanse for himself a people as his own, eager to do what is good. The word of the Lord.
Gospel reading is in the hymnal book, page 967. 967. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. In those days, a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that the whole world should be enrolled. This was the first enrollment when Quirinius was governor of Syria. So all went to be enrolled, each to his own town. And Joseph too went up from Galilee, from the town of Nazareth, to Judea, to the city of David, that is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and family of David, to be enrolled with Mary, his betrothed, who was with child. While they were there, the time came for her to have her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son. She wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. Now, there were shepherds in that region living in the fields and keeping the night watch over their flock. The angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were struck with great fear. The angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for behold, I proclaim to you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. For today in the city of David, a Savior has been born for you, who is Christ and Lord. And this will be a sign for you. You will find an infant wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger." And suddenly, there was a multitude of the heavenly host with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests." The Gospel of the Lord.
when we live the way He lived. So Christmas is the day, the answer that was there. God came to me, like me, to save me from myself. So we together profess our faith. We need help. Those prayers are on the union book, front page inside. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, Creator.
He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and His kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. So our canon law of the church, canon 563, states, quote, no one, whether shepherd or wise man, can approach God here below, except by kneeling before the manger at Bethlehem and adoring Him hidden in the weakness of a newborn child. So today for our prayers, if your knees are okay, please kneel down. And our response to the prayers is, Come, Lord Jesus.
To the dryness of prayer, we welcome you, Lord Jesus.
Come, Lord Jesus.
To the dissatisfaction of useless entertainments, we welcome you, Lord Jesus.
Come, Lord Jesus.
To the desert created on us by our overwork, we welcome you, Lord Jesus.
Come, Lord Jesus.
To our yearning for priorities that matter, we welcome you, Lord Jesus.
Come, Lord Jesus.
To our broken relationships and families, we welcome you, Lord Jesus.
Come, Lord Jesus.
To the darkness of our accumulated sins, we welcome you, Lord Jesus.
Come, Lord Jesus.
To the hopelessness of our addictions, we welcome you, Lord Jesus.
Come, Lord Jesus.
To the emptiness of habits of mind that nourish no one, we welcome you, Lord Jesus.
Come, Lord Jesus.
Let's pray in silence. May the oblation of this day's feast be pleasing to you, O Lord, we pray, that through this most holy exchange we may be found in the likeness of Christ, in whom our nature is united to you, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for in the mystery of the Word made flesh, a new light of your glory has shone upon the eyes of our mind, so that as we recognize in him God made visible, we may be caught up through him in love of things invisible. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and together with Francis our Pope, Stephen our Bishop, and all the clergy, remember the intentions of all these your children. The intentions of all these your sons and daughters and their families. Remember also our parents, brothers, sisters, and children who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all those who have died. In your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray. That with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, our patroness, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Jesus Christ, bring eternal life to all those who receive Please join in singing of the Father's Love Begotten on your worship aid.
Sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Thank you.
Please take the hymnal book, front page inside. We pray together. O sacrament of glory, O sacrament of mine, all praise and all thanksgiving, we have been on the time. We believe that Jesus Christ is really, truly, and substantially present in Holy Communion, body, blood, soul, and divinity. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving, be every moment thine. Mary, Blessed Mother, help us, your children, to experience and develop in the Eucharist a deeper and more intimate relationship with your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us pray. Grant us, we pray, O Lord our God, that we who has gladdened by participation in the feast of our Redeemer's Nativity may through an honorable way of life become worthy of union with him who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Would you please be seated for a minute, please? Thank you so much for being here today. Thank you for your very presence. Dear grandparents, thank you, you are the best. Thank you for finding the time to come with your children and grandchildren. And today begins the octave of Christmas. So remember, it's Friday, weekend mass is as usual, and it's as obligatory they are. So please don't forget. And thanks to all, the choir, the staff, the decoration team, altar flower ministry, and the BNG team, and many others. The children's program, thanks to the DRE and the dear wonderful parents for bringing them. There is a book out there titled Life is Messy. It's a Christmas gift, so please take a copy to every household. And it's a gift of a parishioner family for all of us this day. May I invite all the children to come to here? Please, come faster. All of you children, please. Some are sleeping, that's okay. There are more children there. Come on, you have to be a priest, you talk to me.